Hi, welcome to EPG Parshala Spanish. We are in the paper titled Advanced Spanish Grammar. I am Gaurav Kumar and I teach Spanish at the Center of Spanish, Portuguese, Italian and Latin American Studies in Jawaharlal Nehru University, New Delhi. The title of this module is Periphrasis Verbalis, and the objective is to learn paraphrasing with the various combinations of the infinitive, gerunds, and participle of the verb. Periphrasis verbalis, or phrasal verbs in English, consists of joining of the auxiliary or helping verb with any of the following three forms of the verb in the non-personal format: infinitive, gerund, and the participle. The auxiliary verb is conjugated, but it doesn't convey the meaning, and it is only the other verb in the non-finite, non-personal, that means no subject pronoun like yo, tu, etc. form, that provides the meaning of the periphrasis. The infinitive has already been discussed in earlier chapters, and we shall revise it along with the uses of gerund and the participle. Helper verb, which is conjugated, plus the main verb, which is left unconjugated in the infinitive form. Example, soler plus infinitivo, which means to do something usually. Yo suelo trabajar los fines de semana. I repeat, yo suelo trabajar los fines de semana, which in English means I usually work on weekends. Next example, de niño solía jugar al badminton con mi papá. I repeat, de niño solía jugar al badminton con mi papá. As a child, I used to play badminton with my father. Next example is the case of the verb deber plus the infinitive, which means to have to do something. It denotes compulsion, but not as strong as tener que plus verb format. Some examples: debes leer el Quijote este verano. Have to read El Quijote this summer. It has been found that students generally tend to get confused and use deber with que, like the model of tener que plus verb. So, it should be kept in mind not to use deber que, rather deber should be directly used with the infinitive. The other construction with deber is that of deber de plus infinitive, which is a correct usage, and in English it translates as ought to. Let's see some examples. Ya que te suspendiste la última vez en el examen, esta vez debes de estudiar mucho para sacar un apto. I mean, ya que te suspendiste la última vez en el examen, esta vez debes de estudiar mucho para sacar un apto. In English, it translates as considering that last time you failed in the exam, this time you ought to study a lot to get passing grades. Another sentence would be, debemos de respetarles a nuestros mayores. I repeat, debemos de respetarles a nuestros mayores. We ought to respect our elderly. The next construction is that of empezar a plus infinitive, which means to begin to do something. Example, mi padre ha empezado a pintar mi retrato. I repeat, mi padre ha empezado a pintar mi retrato. In English, my father has begun to paint my portrait. Another example is that of comenzar a plus infinitive. The example of a sentence is comenzó a decir barbaridades. I repeat, comenzó a decir barbaridades. He started talking nonsense. Comenzar por can also be combined with the infinitive to repress a series of actions. Sample sentence would be, comenzamos por mostrar nuestro desacuerdo. I repeat, comenzamos por mostrar nuestro desacuerdo. We started by showing our disagreement. Echarse a plus infinitive is also another construction of verbal paraphrasing, which means to start doing something. La profesora se echó a reír. The professor started laughing. Another example, no sé a qué horas ni cómo me eché a llorar. Lloré y lloré, creo que toda la noche. Al fin, no sé a qué horas ni cómo me eché a llorar. Lloré y lloré, creo que toda la noche. I don't remember at what time I broke into tears. I wept and wept, I think, all night long. Meterse a plus infinitive means to start doing something, but it has more of a negative connotation. Sample sentence, ¿por qué se metió a escribir novelas si era simplemente un abogado? I repeat, ¿por qué se metió a escribir novelas si era simplemente un abogado? In English, why did he get into writing novels if he was just a lawyer? Ponerse a plus infinitive means to start to do something. Sample sentences will make it clear for you. First one, después de la pelea, se puso a hacer las maletas. I repeat, después de la pelea, se puso a hacer las maletas. In English, after the fight, she started packing her bags. Another example is, me tengo que poner a estudiar para el examen del martes. Es pasado mañana. I repeat, me tengo que poner a estudiar para el examen del martes. Es pasado mañana. In English, it translates as, I have to start studying for TLE exam. It's the day after tomorrow. Terminarte plus infinitive means to finish doing something. Examples. No hemos terminado de limpiar los cristales todavía. I repeat. No hemos terminado de limpiar los cristales todavía. In English, it means we haven't finished cleaning the windows yet. Poder plus infinitive, which means to be able to do something. Examples. No puedo ver la tele y estudiar al mismo tiempo. I repeat. No puedo ver la tele y estudiar al mismo tiempo. In English, it means I am not able to watch the TV and study at the same time. Tener que plus infinitive has been already dealt with in earlier chapters, and as you know, it expresses compulsion. Some examples are: tienes que comer más frutas y verduras. I repeat, tienes que comer más frutas y verduras. In English, you have to eat more fruits and vegetables. Another example, tengo que irme, ya es muy tarde. I repeat, tengo que irme, ya es muy tarde. I have to leave, it is very late now. Acabar de plus infinitive means to have just done something. This also you must have learned in the earlier chapters. Some examples are: acababa de salir de casa cuando empezó a llover. I repeat, acababa de salir de casa cuando empezó a llover. In English, it means I had just left the house when it started to rain. Quedar en plus infinitive. Examples. Los dos amigos quedaron en hacer los deberes juntos. I repeat. Los dos amigos quedaron en hacer los deberes juntos. The two friends agreed to do the homework together. Another example would be quedar sin hacer o realizar, which means to remain undone and never carried out respectively. The quedar por this cut. Quedar en infinitive means to agree. Example. Los dos amigos quedaron en hacer los deberes juntos. I repeat. Los dos amigos quedaron en hacer los deberes juntos. In English, it means the two friends agreed to do the homework together. Quedar sin hacer or quedar sin realizar means to remain under or never carried out respectively. Examples. El proyecto de mandar una nave espacial al planeta Saturno se quedó sin realizar. I repeat. El proyecto de mandar una nave espacial al planeta Saturno se quedó sin realizar. In English, it is translated as the project of sending a spaceship to the planet Saturn was never carried out. Another example, por falta de dinero, la construcción del templo se ha quedado sin hacer. I repeat, por falta de dinero, la construcción del templo se ha quedado sin hacer. In English, it is translated as, for the lack of money, the construction of the temple has been left undone. Kedar 4 plus infinitive indicates an action which is incomplete. Sample sentences are, Nos quedaron muchas cosas por ver. I repeat, Nos quedaron muchas cosas por ver. In English, it is said as, We were left with many things to see. Another sentence, Me queda la cama por hacer. I repeat, Me queda la cama por hacer. I have to still do the bed. Acertar a plus infinitive means to manage to do something. El padre estaba tan emocionado al ver el recién nacido que no acertaba a pronunciar palabra. I repeat, el padre estaba tan emocionado al ver al recién nacido que no acertaba a pronunciar palabra. In English, the father was so emotional on seeing the newborn that he couldn't even manage to utter a word. Acostumbrar a plus infinitive means to get used to doing something or getting habituated to. The example, Los indios están acostumbrados a tomar té con leche. I repeat, Los indios están acostumbrados a tomar té con leche. Indians are habituated to having tea with milk. Alcanzar a plus infinitive expresses something that is achieved after a great effort. The example, Después de muchos intentos fracasados, ella alcanzó a hacer la perfecta paella valenciana. I repeat, Después de muchos intentos fracasados, ella alcanzó a hacer la perfecta paella valenciana. In English, it means, After many failed attempts, she finally managed to make the perfect Valencian paella. Cesar de plus infinitive means to cease to do something. Example, El jefe no cesaba de criticar a sus empleados. I repeat, El jefe no cesaba de criticar a sus empleados. In English, the boss never stopped criticizing his employees. Another sentence, Ha cesado de llover. Ya vuelve a empezar el partido del cricket. I repeat, Ha cesado de llover. Ya vuelve a empezar el partido del cricket. In English, it has stopped raining and now the cricket match starts again. Bastar con plus infinitive. It means it was enough or just. Examples. Es tan inocente que basta con preguntarle y te dirá todos los secretos. I repeat, es tan inocente que basta con preguntarle y te dirá todos los secretos. In English, it is, he is so innocent that if you ask him, he will tell you all secrets. Next sentence, para aprobar esta asignatura, basta con asistir a las últimas clases antes del examen final. I repeat, para aprobar esta asignatura, basta con asistir a las últimas clases antes del examen final. In English, it can be translated as, to pass this subject, it is enough to attend the last few classes before the final exam. Let's now see the next case of verbal paraphrasing with the case of the gerunds. Periphrasis verbalis declinatio. It refers to paraphrasing in Spanish where the gerund form of the verb is used. It refers to an action that is in progress. It may be an interrupted process or action that is carried out repeatedly. Andar plus gerundio. It expresses an activity which persisted and continued. Some examples are: El hombre loco anda gritando que el mundo va a acabar. I repeat, el hombre loco anda gritando que el mundo va a acabar. In English, the bad guy goes around shouting that the world is going to end. Another example. Anda haciendo graffiti en las paredes. I repeat, anda haciendo graffiti en las paredes. He keeps doing graffiti on the walls. Acabar plus gerundio means to express the end of a process. Examples: Siempre estos dos hermanos acaban peleándose. I repeat, siempre estos dos hermanos acaban peleándose. In English, these two brothers always end up fighting. Next sentence. Por sus malas costumbres, acabó perdiendo toda su fortuna. I repeat, por sus malas costumbres, acabó perdiendo toda su fortuna. In English, because of his bad habits, he ended up losing all his fortune. Estar plus gerundio is to be doing something. This is the most common way of expressing an action which is in progress. Example, no puedo salir ahora. Estoy estudiando para el examen del martes. I repeat, no puedo salir ahora. Estoy estudiando para el examen del martes. In English, it means, I can't go out now. I'm studying for Tuesday's exam. Seguir plus gerundio means to continue to do something. Let us see some sentences. A pesar de recibir muy poco salario, Laura sigue trabajando para la empresa. I repeat, a pesar de recibir muy poco salario, Laura sigue trabajando para la empresa. In English, in spite of getting very little salary, Laura continues working for the enterprise. Ir plus gerundio is used for an action that is continuing little by little. Examples: Ellos van pagando la deuda a plazos. I repeat, ellos van pagando la deuda a plazos. In English, they are paying the debt in installments. Next sentence. La mayoría de la población de China se va haciendo vieja. I repeat, la mayoría de la población de China se va haciendo vieja. In English, it means the major population of China is getting old. Llevar plus gerundio means the same as hace que for referring to time. Examples: Llevo estudiando español más de 3 años. I repeat. Llevo estudiando español más de 3 años. It is the same as saying in Spanish. Hace más de 3 años que estudio español. I repeat. Hace más de 3 años que estudio español. Both these sentences can be equally translated in English as I am studying Spanish for the last 3 years. Another example, ¿cuántas horas llevas esperando al autobús? I repeat, ¿cuántas horas llevas esperando al autobús? Which is the same as ¿cuántas horas hace que esperas al autobús? I repeat, ¿cuántas horas hace que esperas al autobús? In English, translated as, how many hours have you been waiting for the bus? Quedarse plus continue is used for expressing an action that stays in continuation. Examples, ella se quedó durmiendo hasta las 2 de la tarde. I repeat, ella se quedó durmiendo hasta las 2 de la tarde. In English, she kept sleeping till 2 in the afternoon. Next sentence is, no salí de casa y me quedé trabajando hasta toda la semana. No salí de casa y me quedé trabajando hasta toda la semana. In English, I didn't leave home and I kept working till the whole week. Salir plus gerundio means ganar and perder. Salir plus gerundio. With the verbs ganar and perder, it indicates the end result of an action. Example. Saliste perdiendo en la apuesta. I repeat, saliste perdiendo en la apuesta. You ended up losing the bet. This is the English version of the Spanish sentence. Next example is, salimos ganando la carrera con el nuevo coche. I repeat, salimos ganando la carrera con el nuevo coche. In English, we ended up winning the race with the new car. Venir plus gerundio is used to express repetition of an action and also its origin in the past. Examples, vengo advirtiéndoselo desde que conocí a ella, pero no me hace caso. I repeat, vengo advirtiéndoselo desde que conocí a ella, pero no me hace caso. I have been warning her since I met her, but she doesn't listen to me. This is the English translation of the Spanish sentence. Next sentence is, la historia nos lo viene demostrando. I repeat, la historia nos lo viene demostrando. In English, history has shown it to us. Coming to the next set of verbal paraphrasing, let's see how the verbal paraphrasing is done in the case of the participle. It is used to express an action that is done and completed. The first case is that of andar plus the participle. It expresses the state in which the subject is, highlighting the duration and emphasizing the activity being done by the subject. Examples. Siempre él anda metido en líos. feet. Siempre él anda metido en fríos. In English, he is always involved in fights. Next sentence. Andamos preocupados por los exámenes. I repeat. Andamos preocupados por los exámenes. In English, we are worried because of the exams. Next construction is dar por plus the participle. It is to consider the action to be over or take for granted. Examples. El profesor dio por explicada la lección. I repeat. El profesor dio por explicada la lección. In English, the professor considered the lesson taught. Another example. Todo el trabajo lo doy por hecho. I repeat. Todo el trabajo lo doy por hecho. The whole work, I consider it done, is the English version. Another sentence is, dio por sentado que le iba a acompañar al viaje. I repeat, dio por sentado que le iba a acompañar al viaje. In English, he took for granted that I was accompanying him on the trip. Dejar plus participle expresses a state caused due to an earlier action. Example. El fiebre me ha dejado debilitado. I repeat. El fiebre me ha dejado debilitado. Fever has made me weak. El tsunami dejó arruinado al país. I repeat, el tsunami dejó arruinado el país. In English, the tsunami left the country in ruins. Ir plus participio is used to highlight the physical or mental state of the subject, or can be used for highlighting the quantity, indicating continuity in both cases. Examples. Siempre va pintada hasta las orejas. I repeat. Siempre va pintada hasta las orejas. She is always wearing makeup even in the ears. Next example. Van aprobados tres reglamentos. I repeat. Van aprobados tres reglamentos. Three regulations have been passed. The English version. Llevar plus participio is the same as haber plus participio. Example. Llevo escritos cuatro capítulos de mi tesis. I repeat. Llevo escritos cuatro capítulos de mi tesis. I have written four chapters of my thesis. Quedar o quedarse plus participio indicates a process that is over. Examples. El problema quedó resuelto. I repeat. El problema quedó resuelto. The problem was solved. Mi hermana se quedó sorprendida cuando se lo dije. I repeat. Mi hermana se quedó sorprendida cuando se lo dije. In English, it is, my sister was left surprised when I told it to her. Tener plus participle is used to indicate the completion of an action, repetition or accumulation of an action. Examples. Tengo pensado irme a España durante las navideñas. I repeat. Tengo pensado irme a España durante las navideñas. In English, I have thought of going to Spain during Christmas holidays. Another example, tenéis hechos todos los deberes. I repeat, tenéis hechos todos los deberes. You have completed all the homework. Next sentence, la novela fue un éxito. Ya tienen publicada 8 ediciones. I repeat, la novela fue un éxito. Ya tienen publicadas 8 ediciones. The novel was a success. They already have 8 editions published. Conclusion. At the advanced level, it is necessary to understand the different verbal constructions possible and to effectively use it in your own expression so as to demonstrate a higher command over the language.